Woodturning may look scary, but in the trained hands of Jim Degen, it's safe and lots of fun. Turning, as it's known, is a popular and growing segment of the world of fine craftsmanship that the nonprofit Brookfield Craft Center was created to preserve and promote. Jim Degen is the core faculty member at Brookfield Craft Center, where he teaches several classes in turning. Jim also manages the school's new woodturning studio, which is housed in a restored railroad station.
This piece is nearly finished. It's about an inch thick, and I'm going to leave it that way. That's not the final thickness. We'll take it and we'll coat it with a wax emulsion, which will slow down the drying, and then I'll put it away for about a year. And during that time, it'll slowly dry out. It'll warp a little bit, go out of round, but by slowing the drying, you can prevent it from cracking. And then a year from now, I'll remount it, turn it down to final thickness, and sand it, and it'll be a completed bowl. This is a piece of maple with what we call ambrosia coloring in it. These gray streaks are caused by the ambrosia beetle getting into the wood, and the wood reacts to it and forms this grayish color, and it really adds to the piece significantly. This is Norfolk Island pine from Florida. The interesting thing is with this particular species is that all the branches come out of the trunk at the same point. So the pattern you can get is very unusual with the branches. And this is another piece from the same wood, and again, the branches all coming out at the same point. And that's the natural color that they come out. It's not been touched up. They come out nice and red. This is a piece of kea, which is a species of African mahogany. It turns out it's just a beautiful coloration. Again, natural, not enhanced. Hollow piece. This is a piece of mesquite burl from Texas. Very, very nice interlocking, twisty grain. Very unusual wood. Hard as a rock. This is an unusual looking piece. It's actually a piece of black birch, a local wood, but it started to decay, or the word we use is spalt, which gives it this very intricate, interesting colorization throughout the wood. It makes a very nice piece. And these pieces are what we call natural edge, where they're turned keeping a little bit of the bark on the wood. This one is actually a piece of apple. This one is a maple, a nice white color of the wood. And this little one is a piece of black walnut. Again, done with the natural bark edge. And finally, we can play with some coloring on wood. This is a piece of ash that's been enhanced a little bit with some dye. It gives it a striking pattern and really shows the figure of the grain of the wood. It's just a little bowl, little fun little piece.
The nationally respected craft school is housed in rural Brookfield, Connecticut. A quick visit to the center website, brookfieldcraft.org, will tell the whole story.